Hello guys, welcome back to another Android Studio tutorial. Here this is another example for Android async task with the list view. First here I am going to add a list view into the activity main.xml file. Specify the width as match parent, height as wrap content. Now specify an ID for the list view. Android ID plus ID, I name it as a list view. Now go to the main activity.java file. There is no need of an options menu, so we can remove all these unwanted methods. First, you have to create a variable for list view. So here I create a variable for list view. I name the variable as list view. Now we have to initialize that variable. So list view equal to call define the view by id method r.id dot list view. Okay, now we need to typecast this one into list view. Okay. Now here we have a list view. Now we need some data for the list view. Here is a string array that contains some names. I copy this one and put it here. Now here I am going to use an async task to add each of these names into the list view. So first here we need an adapter for the list view. So here I am going to add an adapter for the list view. List view dot set adapter, and here I am going to add an array adapter, new array adapter that handles string. And for the array adapter method, you have to specify three arguments. First one is the context object. I pass this as context. Now you have to specify a layout file for each of the list item. So here I use android dot r dot layout dot symbol list item 1, and the final argument is the source of data, and here I'm going to specify an array list that handles string, but the array list does not contain any information. It's a blank array list. Okay, so now we have a list view and we set up some adapter for the list view. Now we have to add these names into the list view, and here I am going to add these names into the list view using an async task. So now we have to create a class for async task. So create another class within the main activity. I name the class as my task, and we have to extend async task. Extends async task. Okay, now here you need to specify the generic type for the async task. You have to specify three generics. So here I am going to use void for the three generics. We need to change it later. And here you need to override some method from async task. You need to override the doing background method. Implement methods. This is the only method you must implement. Do in background and click OK. And we need some other methods. First one is the on pre-execute. Now we have to override on progress update method. And final one is on post execute. Okay, so now we have to add these names into the list view through async task. For that, first we have to get the adapter from the list view. So for get the adapter from the list view, here I am going to create a variable for array adapter that handles string. I name it as adapter. and you can get the you can initialize the array adapter variable on the on pre execute method. So here I am going to initialize that variable adapter equal to list view dot get adapter, and we have to typecast this one into array adapter that handle string. Okay, now we get the adapter from the list view. Now we have to add the names into the adapter. For that, we can use the doInBackground method. Okay, so now I need to get each of these name from the string array. For that, here I use a for each loop. Declare some variable, I name it as name. And the array name is names. Okay, now from the for loop, now here I need to call the on progress update method. So I have to call the publish progress method and I pass the name. So here in the async task we have some progress and the type of the progress is string here. So we have to change the generic type of the async task. You have to change the type of the second parameter, it is string. Okay, so here also on progress update method also you need to change the parameter type into string. There is no need of the super keywords, I remove all the super keywords. Okay, now within the on progress update method I am going to add the name into the adapter. So adapter dot add, and we get the name from the first index of this parameter. Okay, so in the for loop we call the publish progress method. So whenever you call the publish progress method from doInBackground method, it will invoke the on progress update method, and in that method I add each of the name into the adapter. So now we add all the name into the adapter. And finally, here after doing all the background job, here I return some result. All the names were added successfully. Okay, so here we use some result, and the type of the result is string. So you have to change the generic type of the async task, the third argument, it is string. And here we return some string from this method, so you have to change that one into string. So here we got the result on post execute method, so you have to change the type of the method argument into string. And for easiness, I just change the parameter name into result. Okay, now display some information to the user. Get the base context or application context and print the result. Just don't make it long, and finally make it visible using show method. Okay, now we successfully add all the names into the adapter and we display some result. Okay, to view the progress on the background, here I'm going to put some posts on the background thread. So here I'm going to sleep the thread for some seconds, thread dot sleep. I sleep the thread for 1 second. Surround it like catch block. Okay. And here there is 50 names on the string array. So there is total of 15 seconds. Okay. So we can now we can check the project. Okay, before going to execute this application, here I forget something. We have to execute the async task. So on the onCreate method, we have to create an object of the myTask class. So here I'm going to create an object of my task class, and by using that object I have to call the execute method. Now we can test the application. Okay, now here we have the application available on this virtual device. Now I run the application. Now here is the output. Each item is added into the list view with 1 second pause. And after 15 seconds, all the items were added into the list view. Okay, now all the 15 names are added into the list view. Okay, now I need a progress bar here for display the progress. So now I am going to add a progress bar. Okay, now go back to the activity main.xml file, and before the list view here I need to add a progress bar. So I add a progress bar and specify the width as match parent, height as wrap content. Specify an ID for the progress bar, so Android ID plus ID. I name it as progress bar. Now we have to specify some style for the progress bar. I need a horizontal progress bar. So Android attribute progress bar style horizontal. Okay. Now go to the main activity.java. So here inside the async task class, I'm going to create a variable for progress bar. I name it as progress bar. Now on the on pre-execute method, here I'm going to initialize the progress bar. So progress bar equal to find viewpy id r dot id dot progress bar and typecast this one into progress bar. Okay, go to the activity main.xml again. Here it is a relative layout. I change that one into linear layout. Linear layout. Okay, also provide an orientation for the linear layout. So Android orientation into vertical. Okay, now go to the main activity.java. So on async task, we initialize the progress bar on pre-execute method. Okay. Now we have to set some parameter for the progress bar. So progress bar dot, I set the maximum into 15 because there are 15 names are available. And current progress bar progress status into 0. Okay, set the set progress into 0. Okay, and finally make the progress bar visible. So progress bar dot call the set visibility method, set visibility, and make it into visible. Okay, and after finishing the background job, we have to hide the progress bar. So inside the on post execute method, I have to hide the progress bar. So progress bar dot set visibility into gone. This will hide the progress bar. Okay. Okay, now we have to update the progress bar. For that, I need some variable here. So here I declare some variable int count and initialize the variable inside the on pre execute method. I initialize the variable with the value 0. So each time whenever this for loop work, it will execute, it will call the on progress update method, and inside on progress update method I'm going to increment the value of variable count by 1. Okay, and here I'm going to set the progress bar that dot set progress and pass the variable count. Okay, now we finish the coding. Now we added a progress bar into the activity main.xml. Now we can check the application. Okay, now here I am going to run the application on a virtual device. Here is the application. So now you can see the progress on the progress bar. So there is 1 second delay, and after 15 seconds all the items were added, and after 15 seconds we hide the progress bar. So now all the items were added and now the progress bar is not visible. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.